Welcome, everybody, to another episode of Ammo Heads Drunk Cooking. I've been drinking a few beers tonight. I ain't scared to say it, and I'm getting hungry. And I thought about some bacon cheeseburgers. How about that? I've got 1 little pound of hamburger meat here. Man, I tell you what, guys, when did hamburger meat get so damn expensive? 1 little pound costs $3. $3. But not to mention gas. It looks like I got some gas today. $3.50 a gallon. But anyway, enough of that. I got 1 pound here. I'm going to make 2 big-ass burgers. Big-ass drunk burgers. Let's go ahead and put some pepper on him. Well, let's wait. Let's wait till we make the patties out first. Let's just separate him out in about half. Looks half to me, I guess. I think this is here a little bigger. And we're going to make 2 big hamburger patties, which will be a half a pound a piece, right? I ain't promising I'm going to eat both of these tonight, but we're going to cook both of them tonight, though. Heard one, big bastard. Get over here in this camera. Everybody knows how to make a hamburger patty. You want to make it a little bit thinner in the middle? Slap her down there. A little bit thinner in the middle. I think it's something to wipe my hands off with just for a second. Alrighty. Ooh, big bastards. Gonna be good. Salt. Salt both of them. Pepper. Get some pepper on there. Looks good to me. Oh, yeah, let's flip it over. Do the same thing. Flip. Flip. Salt. Salt. Pepper. Pepper. What the hell is that? Oh, it's just a big clump of pepper. Alright. Come on over here, guys. Let's see. Where are we at? Right about there, I guess. Hot. Cast iron pan. Feeling good. Starting to heat up a little bit more. For you guys and girls that don't know about cast iron, the more you cook with it, the more it becomes nonstick. I've had this, I guess, only about a year, maybe a year and a half now. Man, it's getting good. Almost like a Teflon. Slap him in there. Slap him in there. All right. Let's just sizzle for a few minutes. Turn it down a little bit. It's a little high. Don't touch your burgers. Let them sit there. Let them cook. I don't know. These are pretty thick. I'm going to let these cook for... What if you want a well done? If you want a burger medium or whatever. I'm going to get these pretty well done. I like my steaks medium or medium rare, but I like my hamburger meat done. So I want them cooking probably about 4 or 5 minutes on that side, and when I get ready to flip them, we'll be back. It's been about 5 or 6 minutes, I guess. I've added some bacon in there with it. Like I said, we're cooking some bacon cheeseburgers tonight. Let's go ahead and give these a flip. I'll turn the heat down. See what it looks like. Oh, yeah. Big old thick mothers. Got a piece of bacon hung on that one. Yeah. at that, guys. Gonna be good. Separate that bacon, let it get some good cooking going on. Another tip, of course, most of you already know, don't mash your burgers. Don't mash them. Don't press down. Leave them juices in there. Let it keep flowing.
So guys, take a look at that for a second. That's right.
Just had a hankering for some bacon cheeseburgers tonight. What red-blooded American don't like bacon cheeseburgers unless you're a veggie? Hey, Pepper Cuts, are you a veggie?
I don't think you are, bro.
Those burgers are going to get done before that bacon is. So, when I get ready to put the cheese on it, I'll get back with you guys. Let's go ahead and take us another swallow here. So I'm going to let the hamburger do its thing. And, I get ready to put the cheese on when I get back. And that bacon's gonna, he's still gonna have a while to do. I like crispy bacon. I don't like it flimsy ass shit. That bacon grease in there mixed in with that hamburger meat's gonna be good.
Be back in a minute.
Those burgers are doing their thing and they're about done, so I turn the heat back up just a little bit. Let's throw some cheese on them. While they're still in the pan here, so it'll melt pretty quick. Oh man, it smells so good. Ah. Oh yeah, he's melting down. You see that one there? Got a paper plate here with some napkins on it. Let's go ahead and pull these burgers off. Big Daddy's. Big Daddy for our Big Daddy. Let them drain off. Whoa. The paper plate wasn't strong enough today. I'm not going to edit this out. No, but hell no. No way. Let's sit him over here. Jesus. Let's get that cheese back on there. Those burgers were too much for the paper plate. That was a hell of a mess. Well, I got most of the cheese back on the burger. Something's on the spatula. You guys know me. No editing. Whatever happens, happens. Let's get that bacon going. Give her a flip. That was funny. Never had that happen before. Of course, I don't think I've ever made half-pound hamburgers before either. So while that's going, I'm going to start over here in this other little pan right here. I've had the heat going in him for a few minutes. Up there. I'm gonna get around here without knocking that camcorder out. I got some pretty big ass buns here. Here's a sesame seed bun and I've got some butter on this side. I'm gonna throw him in there and brown him up real good with that butter. pan's not big enough for both, top and bottom, so I'm gonna do one at a time. I need to pay more attention to my bacon over here. Bacon's looking good, bacon's smelling good. There's the bacon. So, no sense to you guys watching this. When it gets done, I'll plate it up and show it to you guys. Oh, how's that look, guys? See that golden brown top bun? The bottom looks just like it. Let's throw some bacon on it. I think I cooked enough bacon. Well, I cooked plenty of bacon for one. But I like a lot of bacon. Now, how's that for a bacon cheeseburger? Let's put this top on here. Oh, goodness. You can't buy nothing that looks that good in a restaurant. Of course, you can top it with whatever you wanted. Ketchup, mustard, mayonnaise, lettuce, tomato, pickle, or whatever. But I like mine just like that. All right. Thanks, guys, for watching. Another installment of the Drunk Tactical Cooking Channel. Something. Thanks, guys. See ya.